Hey, what's up guys, Jonas again from iGeeks blog. Whether you have been using iPhone or iPad for long or just arrived on the Apple ecosystem, you might not have ideally customized the settings. And in this video, I am going to show you 20 plus iOS settings you should change right now to fine-tune security and privacy along with customize many other things to use your iPhone perfectly. So let's get started. First, let's take a look at privacy settings you should change right now. And first in the list is limit ad tracking. Based on your usage, Apple shows ads that might interest you. However, you can limit the ad tracking to receive less relevant ads. To do it, open Settings app, select Privacy, scroll down and tap on Advertising, and turn on the switch for limit ad tracking. Apple needs to have diagnostic and usage data of your iPhone to improve your overall experience. However, you get the complete freedom to opt out of these things at your own terms. To get control of these things, go back to Privacy in Settings app, then select Location Services, scroll down and hit System Services. On this screen, you can disable the access to a ton of things like location-based alerts, Apple Ad suggestions, iPhone analytics and more. So fine-tune everything as per your needs. At times, in-app ratings and reviews seems to be too distracting, especially when they start popping up time and time again. Fortunately, there is a quick way to turn off such pop-ups. To do so, launch Settings app and head over to iTunes and App Store sections. Then turn off in-app ratings and reviews toggle. The short previews of apps and games are helpful as they let you snap a quick look at what they have to offer. However, they can drain out your iPhone battery and also eat into plenty of your cellular data. But don't worry, as you can easily disable the video autoplay to browse through the App Store with complete peace of mind. To get it done, again go back to iTunes and App Store in Settings app and tap on Video Autoplay. Now you can disable these features completely or allow the videos to play only on Wi-Fi. A 4-digit passcode isn't recommended for a couple of reasons. First, it's a tad easier to guess, and the second, you know how devastating it can be for your sensitive info. Let's launch Settings app and select Face ID or Touch ID. Enter your passcode, scroll down and hit Change Passcode. Again, enter your passcode and tap on the passcode options. From here, I would prefer to set custom alphanumeric passcode to make it more strong and difficult to guess. Next is disable access to Siri, Home Control, Control Center when your device is locked. While it's helpful to quickly access some of the most used things like Siri, Control Center, Wallet and more right from the lock screen, it also exposes your privacy. Thus, it's better to disable the access to such essential features. To do it, launch Settings app, then select Face ID or Touch ID. Slightly swipe down to allow access when locked section. Now you get the option to disable the access to many things like Control Centers, Notification Centers, Siri and more. Turn off the toggles for every feature you wish to protect. Apple's two-factor authentication adds another layer of safeguard to your device. It can go a long way in offering a strong seal to not just your personal device, but also protect your data from falling into the wrong hands. To make sure to keep it enabled, open Settings app, then tap on your Apple ID, and select Password and Security and hit Two-Factor Authentication and then set it up by following the instructions. USB restricted mode is a well-thought-out security feature that seals your iPhone against hacking. It prevents your device from connecting to an accessory if it hasn't been unlocked for more than an hour. To make sure this security is on, head over to Settings app, select Face ID or Touch ID, enter your passcode, then scroll down and be sure the switch for USB accessories is turned off. Don't get confused, because when the switch is on, accessories will be allowed to connect to your device without any restriction. You may have allowed many apps to access your microphone and camera on your iPhone. But did you know that you could completely stop those apps from using your mic or the camera? It's quite simple to put the plug on them. What you have to do is fire up Settings app, then select Privacy, now tap on Microphone and turn off the switch next to the app which you no longer want to use your mic. Similarly, you can tap on Camera and then disable the switch for the apps which you want to stay away from your device camera. What if someone steals your iPhone and starts using the same to blackmail others? Oh, that will be disaster. Why give anyone a chance to endanger your life when you can enable SIM PIN and prevent them from using it? To get going, open Settings app, select Cellular or Mobile Data, then hit SIM PIN and turn on the switch for SIM PIN, enter your PIN and you are done. Safari makes web browsing more secure. You can further customize it to keep spammer or data trackers at bay. To get it done, head into Settings app, then select Safari, scroll down, and under Privacy and Security, you have multiple options like prevent cross-site tracking, block all cookies, get fraudulent website warning, and more. So adjust everything to navigate through the web with more safeguard. iOS automatically locks your iPhone after a predefined time when it doesn't detect any human interaction. It not only prevents unnecessary power consumption, but also stops others from viewing your content. To fine-tune this, open Settings app, select Display and Brightness and hit Auto Lock. Now you should see multiple options like 30 seconds, 1 minute, etc. It's better to keep the auto lock to the minimum level. As the screen automatically dims before 10 seconds, the 30 seconds options would be a bit too short. So choose either 1 or 2 minute options as it can fit into the most of your needs. True Tone and Night Shifts are designed to enhance the viewing experience. While True Tone automatically adapts your iPhone display as per ambient lighting conditions, Night Shift ideally shifts the colors of the display so that your eyes find it more comfortable to view the content. To enable these features, head over to Settings, then Display and Brightness. To bring the True Tone into action, turn on the switch for it. And to activate Night Shift, tap on it and then customize it based on your need. I prefer to have sunset to sunrise because it uses location services to determine time zone of the device, allowing it to calculate the right time to turn the features on and off. Find My iPhone is known to be an advanced device tracking feature, and it can be helpful in letting you find your lost device, so be sure it's enabled. What you have to do is open Settings app, select your profile, then select iCloud and tap on Find My iPhone and ensure that the toggle is on. Imagine a situation where you are watching your favorite Netflix shows. Suddenly, your Wi-Fi connection becomes sloppy and brings your binge watching to a halt. Wouldn't it be better if your device automatically connects to the mobile data when Wi-Fi connection is poor? This is where Wi-Fi Assist comes into the play. To turn it on, fire up Settings app, select Cellular or Mobile Data, scroll down and ensure that Wi-Fi Assist toggle is on. By taking full advantage of high efficiency format, you can reduce the file size of your photos by up to 50%. To me, it's the best way to manage the storage and prevent the device from being cluttered for space. So never fail to give it a shot. To get going, launch Settings app, scroll down and tap on Camera, select Formats and make sure High Efficiency is selected. Turn on Reachability. While big screen iPhones are great for media viewing, web browsing and playing games, they aren't convenient to use with one hand. If you find it a bit uncomfortable to use your device one-handed, you should take advantage of Reachability. To enable it, open Settings app, then select General, then Accessibility, and then turn on the switch for Reachability. Next, to activate these features on iPhone 10 and later series, swipe down from the middle of the bottom row of the apps. On the classic iPhones like iPhone 7 Plus and 8 Plus with Touch ID, you need to double tap on the home button. When it is activated, the content of the top half of the screen will slide down, making it a lot comfortable for your thumb and fingers to interact with them. While keyboard click sound may be helpful in letting you know that you have successfully entered a letter, it may turn out to be annoying stuff, especially during the night or when you are in a meeting. Thankfully, you can easily turn it off. To do it, launch Settings app, select Sounds and Haptics, scroll down and turn off the switch for keyboard clicks. Don't get me wrong, I find autocorrection in the keyboard app very useful as it enables you to type correctly. But at times, it doesn't seem to work spotlessly and may even hinder you from typing fast. If this is the case, you may want to turn it off. To do so, go back to Keyboards in Settings app and then turn off the switch for autocorrection. Emergency SOS is a life-saving feature. It lets you quickly call emergency services by clicking the side buttons 3 times. Knowing how significant this feature is, make sure it is always turned on under Emergency SOS section in Settings app. You can also add emergency contacts in Health app under Medical ID. So after an emergency call ends, your iPhone alerts your emergency contacts with a text message unless you choose to cancel. Your iPhone also sends them your current locations and it keeps updating your emergency contacts when your location changes. We must all root for safe driving, ensuring we follow all the rules carefully. iOS comes with highly appreciated features called Do Not Disturb While Driving that mutes incoming calls, texts, and notifications when you are on the go to prevent accident causing distraction. You can choose to turn it on manually or automatically whenever your iPhone detects a car's acceleration or connects to a car's Bluetooth. To get started, simply open Settings app and head into Do Not Disturb section. Then tap on Activate under Do Not Disturb While Driving. Next, select the preferred option. One thing worth noting is that you can activate these safe driving features from the Control Center as well. But first thing, you have to add it to the Control Center. To do so, go to Settings app, then Control Center, then hit Customize Controls, and then hit the plus button to the left for Do Not Disturb While Driving. Now, it will be available in the Control Center. Apple has introduced a robust parental control feature called Screen Time in iOS 12. You can use this new add-on to not only keep track of your iPhone users but also get rid of smartphone addiction. To get started, open Settings app and then hit Screen Time. Now you have multiple options. Downtime lets you set a schedule during which you don't want to use your device. Based on your need, you can also customize the days to exclude Sunday or put a restriction for only a few hours on a specific day. You can also exclude your choice of apps from the downtime by going to Always Allowed and tap on the plus button to the left of the apps. One more very important thing. Be sure to set the screen time passcode to prevent anyone from making any changes. Simply hit screen time passcode, enter your code and confirm it. That's all guys, these are the number of settings that I think you should change right now. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If yes, like and share this video and subscribe to our channel to catch up with more hands-on tips. I am Dhvanesh signing off and we'll catch you in the next one.